Hey there, and welcome to our virtual resource fair for the College of Fine Arts at the University of Kentucky. My name is Nathan Williams, and I'm the recruiter for the College of Fine Arts. I also happen to be an alum of the program. In 2015, I graduated with two degrees, one in arts administration, and then one in French horn performance. But then it didn't stop there. I continued my education here at UK and received my Master's of Arts Administration as well, and graduated from that program in 2017. Since then, I worked for the local orchestra for about 2 years in their operations department, and now I work full-time recruiting students like yourself, hang out with students when they visit campus, set up tours, private lessons, and I just get them comfortable on campus so that you get all of your questions answered before you begin your time here as a creative type UK Wildcat. And so today I just want to go over the various offerings that we have as a college when it comes to educational programs, our living learning program, and even our life outside of the classroom with all of our various extracurricular activities. So I just want to give you a nice little rundown of each unit first. Our first one is arts administration, and this is one of our smaller units. It has about 120 students. But the cool thing about this department is that there's about 10 concentrations. So you can go into marketing, you can go into finance, you can also look into event management, fundraising, grant writing. There's just endless opportunities with arts administration. And with this program, you have to have a minor or a focus anyways. So for me, when I came in with arts administration, I came in with music. Some students partner dance with arts administration, theater with arts administration. The combinations are really endless, which is really cool about that program. Our second one is the School of Art and Visual Studies. This has about 400 undergraduate students and 5 degrees. And so with that school, you really work on your art studio, art education, art history, and digital media. And same thing with this college. Rarely do our students come in with just one focus. A lot of them mix and match. So a lot of students will do art studio with digital media, arts administration with art studio, and some even dabble into other colleges, such as the business college, the engineering college. Some even go into law after their undergraduate degree. So it's really cool to see where those students go after they receive a visual art undergraduate degree. Our Department of Theater and Dance is also a little smaller, more intimate program. I like to see it as a family. It's about 140 undergraduate students as well. And just like the name of the department, there's a degree in theater and a degree in dance. And the cool thing about those two programs is that just because you're coming to UK and getting a Bachelor of Arts in Theater does not necessarily mean you want to act. And so a lot of the students who come in with a BA in Theater, they will do stuff backstage with the audio, the lights, the production. They will create the sets that you see. They will alter the costumes that you see both in the theater department and in our opera department as well. But it doesn't end there. We definitely think that everything needs to be talent-based. So if you're a really talented freshman, you can be front and center. We don't believe in hierarchy. So if you're a freshman, you don't have to worry about waiting 2 or 3 years to perform on stage if that's what you want to do. But if you want experience being backstage and putting it all together, that's also really cool as well. And then our dance department, we do a lot of modern and ballet and jazz. But some of those students also double major within other colleges. So physical therapy is a great double major. Art administration, even though just go into education and learn how to run and manage their own dance studio as well. And then last but not least, our School of Music, which is one of our most well-known degrees or units. There's about 270 undergraduate students. They come in with one of our three main degrees: liberal arts, music education, and music performance. Music education is really the only degree where you don't see students double majoring unless they come in with a lot of AP credit. Due to the fact that those students have to student teach their last semester, a lot of them do get a buffer semester and take about 4.5 years to get out of that program. But all of our ensembles are open to anyone. So if you marched in high school, but you don't necessarily want to be a music major, but you still want to continue marching, the marching band is open to you. The only requirement is to have marched in high school. So the marching band is a great opportunity to stay involved. You get to attend the football games for free. And if you march in the fall, you have the opportunity to audition for the pep band in the spring to perform at Rupp Arena during basketball season. Same thing goes for our jazz bands, our orchestras, our concert bands, our choirs. We have a cappella groups. We have small ensembles, big ensembles. So it's just really great to see the variety of ensembles that we have, not just in our school of music, but in our entire college. The extracurricular activities, whether it's the Arts Administration Society, it's just really cool to see what our students love to do outside of the classroom and outside of the performing arts. And last but not least, I want to talk about the Living Learning Program. So across campus, we have around 15 communities. So engineering has one, Honors College has one, First Generation, they have one. But the creative arts, we have one, which is conveniently located halfway between our School of Art and Visual Studies and the College of Fine Arts. On North Campus, it's literally across the street from the Gatton Student Center. So you have access to the dining hall, the movie theater, Chick-fil-A, a gym. You're 5 minutes from downtown. And so you're just really close to everything that you need. And so you really don't have to worry about running to class or worrying about missing class because you have to take an Uber or a scooter to class. Everything is really conveniently located, which is so cool. Out of the 200, give or take, freshmen that we brought in this fall, about 100 students in the College of Fine Arts are living there. So we don't require our students to live on campus or live in our community, but we definitely encourage it. We have 5 practice rooms for our musicians. There's a dance studio, there's a writing studio, a classroom, an art studio, and it's just minutes away from where you would take class. And so you would live and learn in the same building, and you're just conveniently located across the heart of campus, which is really great. But this is just the beginning of the conversation. So if you have any other questions regarding your future as a UK Wildcat, you can contact me using this information. So go ahead and screenshot it, and I'll also submit a little post after this with all the information. But we look forward to having you on campus in the fall. And even if you're not going to be a music major or a theater major, all of our ensembles are open to anyone. And we hope that you will join us and will be a creative type in the fall. Congratulations and go Cats!